In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmelite, reflection on the day's readings. It's the 23rd of January, Wednesday of the second week in ordinary time. We are still in the week of prayer for Christian unity. And as we know, from yesterday, 22nd to 27th of this month, there is the World Youth Day happening in Panama from 22 to 27th. Let's listen to the first reading of the day, a reading from the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 7, verses 1 to 3, and then 15 to 17. Brethren, Melchizedek, king of Salem, priest of the Most High God, met Abraham returning from the slaughter of the kings and blessed him. And to him Abraham appointed a tenth part of everything. He is first by translation of his name, King of Righteousness, and then he is also King of Salem, that is, King of Peace. He is without father or mother or genealogy, and has neither beginning of days nor end of life. But resembling the Son of God, he continues a priest forever. This becomes even more evident when another priest arises in the likeness of Melchizedek, who has become a priest not according to a legal requirement, concerning bodily descent, but by the power of an indestructible life. For it is witnessed of him, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My dear brother and sister, Jesus Christ is the eternal and only priest who is the mediator between God and human beings. Comparison is made between Christ and Melchizedek in the reading that we just heard. Melchizedek was both king and priest, which is unique according to the Old Testament traditions. Melchizedek means king of righteousness in the Hebrew language. The word Salem means peace, the Hebrew word shalom. So Melchizedek is King of Peace as well as King of Righteousness. Righteousness and peace are often found together in Scripture. Righteousness and peace. There is no record of the genealogy of Melchizedek, which is significant because most great persons in the Old Testament have their ancestry identified. It was especially important that the priests be able to prove their ancestry. Melchizedek was not an angel or some superhuman creature. He was a real man, a real king, and a real priest in a real city. But as far as the record is concerned, he was not born, nor did he die. In this way, he is a picture of the Lord Jesus Christ, the eternal Son of God. Though Jesus Christ did die, Calvary was not the end. For he rose from the dead and today lives in the power of an endless life. Jesus Christ is a priest after the order of Melchizedek does not imply Melchizedek's priesthood is superior to that of Christ. It only means that all other priesthood of the Old Testament was imperfect except the priesthood of Melchizedek. Now all of us who are baptized participate in the priesthood of Christ, which means as Christ offered himself to God, we need to become a living sacrifice to God. There is no greater sacrifice we can offer than being sinless and spotless in order that we may be consumed by the love of Christ. Are we able to become that living sacrifice? Let us pray. My dear brother and sister, as we find in the Bible diary today, it's the birthday of Genevieve Noronha from Attur Karkal, Melvita Rodriguez from Anegudde, Jessica D'Souza from Dubai, Dina Pereira Nityadar Nagar. We all wish you a happy birthday, my dear friends. May God bless your life with His choicest blessings. We also join with Reverend Father John Barbosa in praising and thanking God for His mercy and blessings. And we pray for the departed soul of F.J. Pereira Bantwal and Valerian Pais Arante Kundapur. May the Lord grant them eternal rest. Along with these particular intentions, my dear friends, we pray for the unity among the Christians and also for all the youth gathered at Panama for the World Youth Day. We also remember our own personal intentions, intentions of those brothers and sisters who have sent their prayer requests. Christ the eternal priest, help us to be faithful to our baptismal call. Amen. This is Father Stephen Pereira, Carmelite priest. And my WhatsApp number is 94812-63229. Let's pray for God's blessings. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. See you tomorrow. Have a great day. Bye-bye.